Hello students, welcome to the channel Pharma for You. So today we are going to discuss about the amino acids and their classifications and their properties. So if you are watching the video first time on our channel, so please like, share, subscribe. Students, moving on our first what are the amino acids and what is amino acids. So amino acids are a group of organic compounds containing two functional groups, that is amino and carboxyl. The amino group is NH2 is a basic, while the carboxylic COOH is acidic in nature. So here we have a general structure of the amino acid, that is the amino acids are termed as alpha amino acids if both the carboxyl and amino groups are attached to the same carbon atom. Let's have a structure of carbon is attached with NH2 and COOH with same carbon, so it is an alpha carbon. Students, just try to note down in your copy or notebook. Next, we are moving on this. That is a carboxyl group and this is an amino group. So the definition says that the amino acids are termed as alpha amino acids if both the carboxyl and amino groups are attached to the carbon atom. So next is, the amino acids are mostly exist in the ionized form in the biological system, that is COO minus, we can observe with the blue color, and the NH3 plus with the black color. So moving on the classification, that is the ionized form. So moving on the classification of the amino acids, it is important for the competitive exams students, that is the NIPER exam and the drug inspector exam, and the main focus in GPAT exam, actually what we for which we are preparing. The first one is amino acid classification based on the structure, classification of amino acids based on polarity, nutritional classification of amino acids, amino acid classification based on their metabolic fate. So these are the classification. First one is amino acid classification based on the structure. So classification of amino acid is based on the structure and chemical nature. Each amino acid is assigned a three letter or one letter symbol. These symbols are commonly used to represent the amino acids in protein structure. The 20 amino acids found in proteins are divided into 7 distinct groups. So moving on the structures, amino acids with aliphatic side chains. So first of all, we have to understand that what is aliphatic and what is aromatic. So aliphatic is the open chain, that is CH3 minus CH2, CH3, CH2, CH3. It's an example, students. And what is aromatic? Aromatic is a cyclic structure, that is, for example, benzene. So moving on, this group consists of the most simple amino acids, that is glycine, alanine, valine, leucine, and isoleucine. So student, there is a task to learn these amino acids with the tricks. So here we have a trick, that is elephant lives in Lucy's gum. So how to learn? That is elephant denotes aliphatic and Lucy denotes leucine and G denotes glycine, A denotes alanine and V denotes valine. So students, just try to learn with this trick. I hope that this trick is very easy and to memorize this. Next one is, here we have a structure of these compounds, that is glycine. The structure is there. So here we observe that the general structure is also there, that is CH3 attached with COO minus and with the same carbon NH3 plus. So here it's a general structure. Students, in every structure of amino acid there is a general structure which is written with the black headings. So let's see another structure, that is of alanine. So alanine structure is, that is one carbon is extra attached to the general structure. Here we observe that in above glycine structure there is hydrogen attached, but in alanine structure there is an extra carbon attached to the general structure. Next is the valine. The structure is this. You can write in a copy. Now moving on, the next structure, that is leucine. The structure of leucine is this, that is the general structure plus CH2 with the written with a red color. Next structure of this isoleucine. So the isoleucine structure is this. So moving on, the next classification, that is hydroxyl group containing amino acids. Serine, threonine and tyrosine are hydroxyl group containing amino acids. Tyrosine, being aromatic in nature, is usually considered under aromatic amino acid. Actually, students, tyrosine is also under an hydroxyl group containing amino acid, and it is also in aromatic in nature. So it is also considered in under aromatic amino acid. So here we have a trick to learn this. Sera and tyri having three alcohol bottles means hydroxyl, we denote OH. So there are three amino acids, that is serine, tyrosine and threonine. The structure of serine is this, and tyrosine structure is this, and threonine structure is this. So we can observe that OH is attached with the amino acid, that is the hydroxyl group containing amino acids. So students, try to learn these amino acid with structure. I hope these notes is making a more easier for you to learn the amino acids with their classifications. Next one is sulfur containing amino acids, that is cysteine, and the structure of cysteine is this. And next one is methionine. We can observe that the sulfur is attached with the general structure. So these are the sulfur containing amino acids. Next one is acidic amino acid and their amides. Students, there are four amino acids which are acidic in nature, that is the aspartic acid, and its structure is this. Next is asparagine. Its structure is this, and here we have a next one is glutamic acid, and fourth one is glutamine. It shouldn't try to note down in your notebooks with their specific structures and learn them with very ease. So next one classification is basic amino acids. So the first one is under basic amino acids, that is lysine. And the structure of lysine is this. Arginine, and the structure of arginine is this. Histidine, and the structure of this. So there are three amino acids which are basic in nature, that is lysine, arginine and histidine. Student, you can also learn with the trick. Actually, it is not mentioned in this. The trick is that the basic tool of farmer is hull. Means basic amino acids, and H for histidine, A for arginine, L for lysine, HAL, H-A-L. So we can observe that in a histidine structure, there is a specific structure, that is the group is present, that is a imidazole ring. So mention the name of this ring, that is a imidazole ring. Aromatic amino acids. Now the phenylalanine, first one is, that is aromatic as we observed in the structure, that there is a aromatic structure in this phenylalanine. Next one is tyrosine. Here we have also aromatic in this structure. And next one is tryptophan. So it's an these are the three amino acids which are aromatic amino acids. Next one is amino acids. Student, many times the question arises in exam that which is the amino acid. So the only one amino acid is there, that is proline. And here we have a structure of proline is this, but it is very simple as we observed from this diagram. So moving on the classification based on polarity. Next, first one is non-polar amino acids. That is their examples. Second one is polar amino acids with no charge on R group. The examples are this. And third one is polar amino acids with positive R groups. Their example are written in this. So next one, classification is based on nutritional classification. That is, it is very important actually, students. So in this, the essential amino acids, it is also known as indispensable amino acids. So what are they? The amino acids which can't be synthesized by the body and therefore need to be supplied through the diet are called essential amino acids. These are those amino acids which we take or from the extra diets, that are what we take in terms of to make proteins actually. So the essential amino acids are, so trick to learn the essential amino acids is Tyree came with three essential bottles in VIP mole. So here Tyree denotes tryptophan and three denotes threonine and V denotes valine, I denotes isoleucine and P denotes phenylalanine, H denotes histidine, A denotes arginine, L denotes leucine, and again L denotes lysine. So I hope students, this trick is very easy to memorize for you. So again, the trick is Tyree came with three essential bottles in VIP mole, as its sentence denotes the essential amino acids. So please note down in your notebook and try to get learn within minutes. Next one is non-essential amino acids. So here the what are the non-essential amino acids? Actually, the body can synthesize about 10 amino acids to meet the biological needs. Hence, they need not to be consumed in the diet. Actually, the essential amino acids are those which we can consume through the diet, and they are not non-essential amino acids are not to be consumed in the diet. So here we are having examples of non-essential amino acids. So please, next one is amino acid classification based on their metabolic phase. The first one is glycogenic amino acids. So what are they? These amino acids can serve as a precursor for the formation of glucose or glycogen in the body. Example, alanine, aspartate, glycine, methionine. Next one is ketogenic amino acid. What are they? Fat can be synthesized from these amino acids actually. Two amino acids are responsible for this. That is, leucine and lysine are exclusively ketogenic. So students, that's all in this video. Next video, we are coming with the physical properties and chemical properties of amino acids. So please stay connected and keep supporting. Please like.